The speaker is not telling you what to think. He's not doing propaganda. This is a horrible thing, propaganda. He's not telling you how to act, what to think, what to believe, and so on. But together, we are investigating the catastrophe that is taking place in the world, outside of us, the utter ruthlessness that is taking, violence, cut, and all the rest of it. And also, inwardly, each human being, the extraordinary conflict that is going on. Together, we are examining, taking the journey together, perhaps hand in hand. So our consciousness has been programmed for thousands and thousands of years. And we have been conditioned, programmed, wired, if you like to put it that way, to think as individuals, to think as separate entities, struggling, conflict, from the moment you are born till you die. We are programmed to it. We have accepted it. We have never challenged, we have never asked, if it is possible to live a life totally, absolutely without conflict. We have never asked it, and therefore we never learn about it. We repeat. It's part of our existence to be in conflict. Nature is in conflict, that's our argument. And progress is through conflict. That's what we have been programmed for millions of years. And the religious organizations throughout the world have maintained this individual salvation. And we are questioning very seriously whether there is an individual consciousness, whether you as a human being have a separate consciousness from the rest of mankind. You have to answer this, not just play with it. See the importance of this, please. This is not something casual. This is very, very serious. Desperately serious. My consciousness and yours, if we have been brought up, programmed, conditioned to the individual, then my consciousness is all this activities of thought. Fear is thought. We'll go into that present. Pursuit of pleasure is the movement of thought. And the suffering, the anxiety, the uncertainty, the deep regrets, wounds, the burden of centuries of sorrow is part of thought. Thought is responsible for all this. what we call love has become sensual pleasure, something desire to be desired. And so on. So it is not, for one may point out, that you are merely listening to some ideas, to some conclusions. We are not talking about conclusions, beliefs, ideas. We are together looking at this world that human beings have produced, for which all of us are responsible. So, first, we must be clear in our understanding, at whatever level that understanding be, whether it is intellectual understanding, which is merely verbal, or the understanding of the deep significance. And that understanding acts. We have come to a point where we have to make a decision, not by the exercise of will, but the decision that naturally will take place when we begin to understand the whole nature and the structure of the world outside of us and inside. That perception will bring about a decision, action.